Good evening. Are you guys ready? Can we start?
Yes,
Chalo. So my first question for you guys, who can tell me what integers are?
sir. Sir, actually, I haven't learned anything about this, and I don't know even what is.
Okay, anyone else who has any idea about integers? Hi, Ridhima. Is it Pragya?
Yeah, even I want to say
It's
Okay.
me.
Yeah. Okay. Both of you can give your answers. Pragya, please go ahead.
Integers are something like there's like 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4, but there's no number before 0 in the whole number system. So in the integer system, there are numbers before 0, that is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So minus numbers are before 0, and positive numbers are on the other side of the 0.
Okay, great. Vamika, your chance. You can speak now.
Yes, I just wanted to share a fact that it's not that zero is not an integer. Zero is neither positive or negative, but it is an integer.
Okay. And Fawaz, do you have something to say? All right. So guys, before we understand what integers are, there are certain other concepts or terminologies that we have to understand. So let's start with our session. I hope all of you can see my screen. It says Mathematics Integer Session 1. Can you see what I'm writing? Just to be sure.
Yeah,
Okay.
ma'am.
Right. And Pragya says that zero was used to separate the positives from the negatives. Yes, exactly. Zero is something that acts as a wall. Where does it act as a wall on? It acts as a wall in the number line. Right. So the first topic that we have is something called natural numbers. Now, in the understanding of natural numbers, guys, it is very important to know this term, counting numbers. Whenever you hear the word natural numbers, understand that these are the numbers you can count. I have one pen, I have two pens, I have three pens, I have four books, I have five books, I have six books. These are numbers that I can actually count. And therefore, natural numbers are denoted by n, as you can see in the bracket. Now, natural numbers, obviously, because I can count, there has to be something in front of me that I should be able to count. So it is either one book or one pen, two books or two pens, three, four, and so on. Therefore, natural numbers start with one because they are counting numbers. Are we very clear with the concept of natural numbers?
Yes,
Right. Now, the second concept that we understand over here are whole numbers. Whole numbers are represented or denoted by a W. Now, we just learned what natural numbers are. We just understood that these are counting numbers. When I have natural numbers and I add this very important number called zero, this entire set becomes something called whole numbers. That is, whole numbers therefore start from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Is the difference very clear?
So,
Now,
can I ask one thing?
yeah.
That these general are also used for counting, right? Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 0 are
Correct,
even
correct.
counting. Then why are they these whole numbers not known as counting numbers?
Correct, I'm coming to that. Now, when I'm talking about natural numbers, I'm talking only about the positive integers. Now, if I have to understand what zero means, zero is basically a perfect situation. Zero means nothing. For example, if I subtract 4 from 5, what do I get? What is 5 minus 4?
5 minus 4, 1.
5 minus 4 is 1. That means there is something that is left. But what if I say, what is 5 minus 5? What do you get when you subtract 5 from 5?
Still nothing.
Nothing. Can you count that?
No.
Does it exist? But is it actually important for you to understand what the significance of zero is? We cannot count zero, but we are able to tell that there is nothing left when I have 5 apples and I eat all 5 apples. If I have 5 pens and I take away all 5 pens, what is left? There is nothing that is left. That means it's a perfect situation. Zero has that significance. That's a very common question that people ask. What is the significance of zero? It gives us a very perfect situation. Now, In order to understand the concept of integers perfectly, we have to understand the concept of the number line. We will come to that. Now, what is it then? What is the next thing? And before I move on, what is the next thing that I have to discuss? For example, if I have a number line. Now, Pragya said that 0 was used to separate the positives from the negatives. Remember, 0 is the number that falls exactly in the middle of the number line. All of you agree with me? Exactly in the middle line.
Zero.
Right. If I have to put a number, it is 0. Now, there are infinite numbers to the right hand side of 0. There are infinite numbers to the left hand side of 0. All of you guys agree. But 0 is that wall. It is the one exactly in between that is separating the two sides. All right. Now, all the numbers to the right hand side of 0, that is this side, are all positive. All of you agree with me? All the numbers to the left hand side of 0 are all negative. That is the reason 0 is considered a wall. Now, all these positive ones, these are called positive integers. That means, can I say that natural numbers are also called positive integers? All of you agree with me? They start with 1, right? Now, if I talk about whole numbers, that means I am including 0. 0 plus positive integers. But guys, 0, it is very important to understand that 0 is neither positive nor negative. Someone pointed this out when I asked you about integers. You spoke about 0. Now, that is where 0 becomes really important. When I include 0 along with all the natural numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on, that is 0 plus positive integers. This segment or this part or this set is known as non-negative numbers. Why are they known as non-negative numbers? Because we haven't moved to the left side of 0. All of you agree with me? When I move to the left of 0, what are the numbers that start? All of them become negative. But from towards the right hand side of 0, all of them are positive. But if I take 0 and if I take all the numbers to the right hand side of 0, what do I get? I get non-negative numbers. Is this concept very clear for all of you?
Sir, I didn't understand about non-negative numbers.
Okay.
We could call them as positive integers, right?
Correct. So, right. Towards the right hand side of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, all these are known as positive integers. But what is 0? 0 is neither negative nor positive, right? Neha, are you following? 0 is neither negative nor positive.
Yes, sir, I'm following.
Correct. If I move to the left hand side of 0, all the numbers become negative. You agree with me?
Yeah.
But now I am not moving to the left hand side of 0. I'm stopping at 0. I am counting numbers from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. That is the whole number set. So whole numbers are also called non-negative numbers. Why? Because I haven't yet gone below 0. I haven't moved under 0. Less than 0. Is it clear now?
Yes, sir. But what I need to ask is, natural numbers are positive integers.
Correct.
And 0 and the whole numbers are non-negative numbers.
Correct.
Then we could also call non-negative means they are positive, right? Then whole numbers are also positive numbers.
Correct. But whole number has this one additional number called 0. Now, what is 0? Is 0 positive or negative?
Neither.
Exactly. That is the reason the difference is coming. Are you clear?
Yeah.
Yeah. So because of this issue or this logic that 0 is neither positive nor negative, we can say that whole numbers are non-negative numbers because we haven't moved to the left side of 0. Now on the next slide, I am going to explain the number line in more detail so that all these concepts are much clearer.